I'm gonna tell you right here tonight. Alright? Y'all see I'm on, you see what I'm on, right? I'm gonna explain to you. For all you haters, don't even come in the chat because I'm blocking you off rip. Don't come in the chat. Give me all the dislikes you want. It doesn't matter. Come in the chat. I looked at it. I seen the dislikes before I even got on. So don't even come in the chat because I'm blocking you off the rip. I'm blocking you off the rip. Period. No ifs, ands, or buts about you getting blocked off the rip. You said I'm not even playing with you today. Cause I'm in my feelings. That's right. I'm in my feelings. No, ain't nothing good. Ain't nothing good. Ain't nothing good, Chris K, for life. Ain't nothing good right now. Nothing. Nothing. Nothing good. Feel me? And that's how I feel. It's a war going on outside. You can't escape from. You can run, but you can't hop over these streets that we done took. Walking with your head down, scared to look, shook, cause ain't no such things as halfway crooks. You're never around when the beef cooks. Feel me? You know what I'm saying? Hey, Google, stop. Hey, Google, stop. Let me explain some. I'm explaining something to some Hurricane fans, right? I'm on a Facebook chat today, right? And there are actually Hurricane's parents on my Facebook chats. See, y'all, people don't understand. Like, I really talk to these kids' parents. I really talk to these kids' parents. Like, for real, I talk to these kids' parents, man. And so I get to know them. We have conversations. I have the utmost respect for them. But you know that doesn't mean anything, you know. Your credibility doesn't mean anything. You have fans saying, you know what I'm saying? Whatever, you know. He got a shot. No, he didn't. He never got a shot. Never got a shot. So stop lying. Stop lying to yourself. Saying he got a shot. If you don't like what I got to say, give me a dislike and get off the chat. It's that simple. He knew he wasn't going to get a shot next year. So that's the reason why I'm glad he's going. But he'll always be more of a Hurricane than Manny Diaz or Mark Richt for the way they treated him. He'll always be. There are two jerseys. The three next jerseys that are going on my wall will be Jerome Brown, Ray Lewis, Ed Reed, and Nikoski Perry. Period. Because, see, I'm always with the underdog, especially when he was a true, True Kane, bro. Nope. 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 But wherever he go, I wish. See, I'm rooting for him wherever he go. And I can tell you this, and I say it again over and over again. Wherever he goes, if they play against Miami, I'm rooting for him. I'm rooting for him to win. Straight up. But I'm in a live stream with some of DJ Ivy. I'm in a live stream on Facebook there with some of DJ Ivy family. Some of his family's in a live stream. Right? And the disrespect that kid took. I also talked to some of Nesta people. After the bowl, Saturday or Sunday. I talked to some of Nesta people, right? Do you know that these kids feel like Miami Hurricane fans basically hate them? Now I'm just being straight up honest with you. I'm being for real. I'm not lying to you. So you can keep the dislikes coming and you don't have to hit the like button. It is what it is. I don't want him going to UCF, Norman. I want him going to a school that's going to play us. I want him to beat us. That's what I want. That's what I want. I want him to beat us. I'm just being honest with you. Or win a national championship. I'm not talking about no other player on the roster right now about starting that quarterback or none of that. I don't care about none of that. And I also talked to somebody like, but I'm gonna leave that alone, man. Oh yeah. These are players. What's going on, Renegade? How you doing, bro? These players who put their heart and soul out there for this fan base. And like I say, bro, I don't have to lie to you, man. Like, I'm dead serious. I'm so blessed to where a lot of these players listen to me. A lot of the coaches don't like me, but a lot of the parents love me. And I'm so blessed to be able to talk to a lot of these kids' parents, man. I never put their name out there. But these kids this year, truly, truly went through so much. Nikoski Perry never quit on Miami, but Manny Diaz quit on Miami. Let's think about that. And I got 89 watching, and for everybody who like me, and y'all sitting there watching the dislikes catch up to the likes, and y'all supposed to be 1219 family, and I'm sitting here watching the dislikes almost past the likes. Like, how? I feel how the kids feel. I'm serious. How you come into the chat? Got 35 likes, 21 dislikes, but 89 in the chat. I don't get it. Ain't there's nothing good, Mating Day. It's nothing good. Nothing good today. Why shouldn't I worry about the likes, Victoria? I mean, I'm not asking for much. I mean, I'm here all the time. I show love. Appreciate you, David. Appreciate you, Kane's Juice, man. Like the video said, one of my saddest days as a Hurricane fan. This is one of my saddest days as a Hurricane fan, bro. It wasn't just about favoritism. It had a lot to do, and this is why people get mad. It had a lot to do with race. Michael, I'm a Knicks fan. I don't care about the Knicks right now, bro. I don't care about the Knicks right now. Somebody told me that people were buying dislikes for my channel. Somebody told me that people were buying bots to dislike my channel. Somebody did tell me that. Elliot was in the chat today. Elliot seen some of the players' parents in my Facebook chat today. I'm sitting here talking about Perry. And I had a dude actually say, "Fuck you, Zo. Fuck you." Right? Not knowing that I got Perry's uncle in the chat. Not knowing that. Oh no, the dislikes don't stop my flow. The people not. You said the dislikes just let you know people want to stop your flow. Nah, if people hit the like, if people would hit the like button as much as the dislike button, you can't stop my flow anyway. They picked everybody over him. I had about 7 players, family members in my Facebook. Elliot was in there. Elliot couldn't vouch for that. Okay. He's more like I said, just think about it. People want to keep saying, give Manny more time, right? And I say the same thing. Give Manny more time. Say the same thing, right? I made this headset. Everything that I have, I almost make on my own. Just like Victoria's championship belt, if you guys want to see it. Just like Victoria's championship belt. This is Victoria's belt. Not worrying about Martell. Nikolsky was true to this program from day one. And I made this belt and I'm giving it to Victoria. She didn't have to buy it. She earned it. She earned this belt, so it belongs to her. It's sad. I'm almost at tears because I'm happy for him. Block. That's simple. Don't even show that comment. Block. Don't even show that. Block. I ain't gotta hit you. Block. That's simple. Block. You don't have to come in and say nothing. You block. That's simple. It's a block party tonight. I don't care if you've been on this channel for 10 years. You come at me tonight, you're getting blocked. Tonight is not the night to come at me. You're getting blocked. I don't care. You've been on the channel 10 years. You come at me with some nonsense because I'm not attacking anybody. But I am saying this. The Miami Hurricane fan base. You're not here, George. I don't want to hear about George. I'm not talking about another quarterback right now. Okay? I'm not talking about no other quarterback, not even on Miami roster. So loyal. How do you expect, right? How do you expect to have recruits want to come to Miami and they see this? Like, how do you expect recruits? And then we say, we blame the players for everything. And I blame the coaches. And I say I'm going to start doing both. But at the same time, can anybody name me? Oh yeah. Can anybody name me? Manny Diaz has been there for 5 years. Manny Diaz has been in Miami for 5 years, right? 5 years, right? Name me any recruit. Name me any player. Name me five players. That's one player per year. Name me five players that Manny Diaz has developed. It's only one player per year. He's been there 5 years. 3 years as a defensive coordinator, 2 years as head coach. Name me five players that he's developed in 5 years. But all we do is we depend on a transfer portal. We depend on a transfer portal. I I wouldn't want him to come back. I don't know. That's one player. I mean, and I'm a, like I said, I was a Diaz fan. I could tell you right now, if we don't win 10 games next year and play for the ACC championship and at least keep that game within 3 points, I want Manny Diaz fired next year. I want him fired next year. He didn't develop Michael Jackson or Red Wine. He didn't develop, that's Mike Rump developed them two. He didn't develop neither one of them two. Because when he was a defensive coordinator, he was on linebackers. So he didn't develop neither one of those two. Michael Jackson or Red Wine. He developed neither one of those two. And if you want to go as a defensive staff, then that's two players. Appreciate that $5 donation, Reggie. Reggie always showing love. If y'all gonna see me wearing a Gator shirt with Nikoski Perry number, if you go to the Gators. As a defensive coordinator, who did he develop? Who got better under him as a defensive coordinator? Exactly, Norman. David, as a defensive coordinator, who got better under him? All of the players that were good under him were Al Golden players. As a defensive coordinator, but if you want to go as a whole defense, you gave me three players. You still ain't gave me five in 5 years. That has gotten better. This is why we depend so much on the transfer portal. This is why we depend so much on the transfer portal. Oh, I promise you, I will have a Nikoski Perry Gator jersey. I promise you. If the Gators were to play against Miami and Nikoski Perry was the starting run, okay, cool. And above me out of no position that he coached, but these are the players that we naming. Okay, that's four. Okay. And Red Wine to give you five. And I would root for the Gators. I would root for Perry to throw for 30,000 yards against a Manny Diaz coach defense. I would root for Perry to throw for 30,000 yards against a Manny Diaz coach defense. Because what he has, this has been consistent, man. Transfer report not a bad look for coaches, for recruits. He ain't developed Jenkins. Jenkins will develop what he got there. Yep. He developing Zion. Everybody else was basically a finished project. Kwon was the same guy from year one as he was in year four. So was Red Wine. Yeah, Al Golden recruited Perry. I don't want nobody from South Carolina. You know what he's afraid of? You know what they're afraid of, man? They're afraid of bringing in coaches from Miami. Manny Diaz is afraid of bringing in somebody in there with a voice. That's why so many Hurricane fans hate me, because I call it exactly what it is. Bullshit. I call it what it is, bullshit. He didn't develop Joe Jackson. Joe Jackson had one or two good years, and he left. He didn't develop Joe Jackson. Joe Jackson hauled ass, so he did not lose his skill set. He ain't developed Joe Jackson. Manny Diaz fan, I hate to tell you this. This ain't the night for you. This ain't the night for you, Manny Diaz fan. Because you might be Manny Diaz. Ain't the night for you. Time out. This ain't the night for Manny Diaz fan. Time out. Manny gets no props over here tonight. Time out. You go in time out, Manny Diaz fan. Why wouldn't I put him in timeout? Why wouldn't I put him in timeout? They made Perry leave. Why wouldn't I put him in timeout? He didn't develop Kendrick Norton. Kendrick Norton was on the same level when he got as when he left. See, y'all just naming players because they went to the NFL. But he didn't make those players better, is what I'm saying. That's why he has to keep going to get transfer portal kids. Yep. Kendrick Norton was already developed. Russo was already developed. Gregory Russo was that dude when he got there. He didn't make Russo better. Matter of fact, he didn't even want to play Russo. He didn't even want to play Russo. Yep, he made Robert Knowles. There go another transfer. Robert Knowles, yep, another transfer portal. He didn't make Al Golden players look good. He can't, and if he made, why can't he make his own players look good then? Why can't he make his own players look good, huh? Why, G. Carson? Why can't he make his own players look good, huh? Huh? Why? Why? So that mean he can't recruit. Nope. That mean he can't recruit. He made Al Golden players look good, but he can't make his own players look good. That don't make no sense to me. The players he recruited, because he's been there 5 years. So all of these players now, he recruited. He can't make his players look good. Why is that? Why is that? Why is that? He gonna hire his daddy. He gonna hire his daddy to be the quarterback coach. All Haitians better get him off of the offense. If you a Haitian and he hire his daddy, you bet not be on offense. Oh, my bad. He did come. Yeah, he did. He had Packy in front of him. I never followed Manny. Even when I was a fan of his. And you hear me say was. I don't think he can ever. G. Carson. It bugs me out when I said the defense was only bad this year. And I'm pretty sure you was part of the chat that's saying it was bad last year. But I don't know. Because I'm pretty sure you're one of the ones that want. You're one of the ones that want. That want Blake Baker fired, right? So what you're saying, G. Carson, is, are you going to give Manny the credit if the defense is good? And you're going to blame Blake Baker if the defense is bad? That's exactly what he wants you to do. You're doing exactly what he wants you to do. You've proven my point for me. You're doing exactly what he wants you to do. How long Perry going to be a victim? Red last, I can tell you this here, Daniel Young. How long are you going to be in timeout? How long are you going to be in timeout? Pip. How long are you going to be in timeout? He won the starting job. Remember, he clearly won the starting job in 2018 over Jaren Williams. Jaren Williams didn't win it. He won most improved player. Jaren Williams didn't win it. He won the starting job and they took it from him. They took it from him. So tonight is not the night to come over here trash talking Perry. It's not the night. Not the night. And I'm not even going to curse nobody out. I'm good. I'm sipping on a $65 bottle of 1800. I'm good. I ain't got to work tomorrow. I'm good. His offense was suspect all the way until Nikoski Perry got in the game against Oklahoma State. His offense was suspect all the way. His offense wasn't a suspect in that game against Oklahoma State. But see, Miami fans have to be to blame for this too, like I said. Because they kill Miami players, man. They kill Miami players. Al Golden had a number eight recruiting class. He always had a top 25 recruiting class. Even with sanctions and all that. He always had that. He hired his brother as the defensive coordinator. That was the problem. Oh, yeah. You know I'm getting lit. This 1800, you know I'm getting lit. Malik Rozier came out and said Perry was the best quarterback they had. He said it. Derek King came out and said this year that Nikoski had the strongest and most accurate arm of all of the quarterbacks. Derek King said that. Derek King said he had the strongest. He had the strongest and he was the most accurate quarterback. I'm just like I said. I'm not going to sit. And what bugs me out is, I'm not cursing. I'm not yelling. I'm not screaming. I'm not doing none of that that people want me to do. I'm not doing nothing. I'm just sitting here in my funeral. Yeah, but I hope he throw for. This bottle ain't 5288. The smaller bottle is 5288. This is the bigger bottle. The smaller bottle is 5288. And this is the aged bottle. The smaller bottle was 5288. But anyway, If he can get it for 52.88, that's good. I'm up in South Carolina. It might be more up here. Are we comparing bottles? Like, serious? That's what we doing? I got a bar. Y'all don't never. I drink top shelf liquor, so let's not even talk about it, man. And $52.88 for a bottle of liquor is top shelf liquor. So I'm in mourning too, man. Well, this ain't. I'm not even pissed. Unknown Faith, I'm not even pissed. I'm disappointed, bro. Oh, I'm not drinking my sorrows, bro. Believe me. I'm not drinking my sorrows. I drink every chat just to chill out. I got Xannies. I don't need weed. I got Xanax. I don't need weed. I got Xanax. I'm legal, man. I can't smoke weed. My job will fire me. Dude, mad cuz you off tomorrow sipping. He mad cuz I'm off tomorrow and I'm getting paid for being off tomorrow. I film for my job, so people know I got one. Nah, serious though, man. Yeah, y'all, it's legal in a lot of cities, in a lot of states. That doesn't mean that jobs have to recognize it. Yeah, it could be legal in that state, but the job still can deny it. He claims to be a Miami guy, but only gets transfer portal kids, man. That's sad. Like I say, and people can hate me people can hate me all they want. You know why I know love me, man? I know the student athletes love me because I talk to a lot of them. I know their parents love me. Because I stick up for them. So that matters more to me than anything. And like I said, that means more to me than anything, bro. Oh, you always got me, man. A lot of people don't like me, Dennis. A lot of people don't like me because I actually have... It's amazing that Miami Hurricane fans don't even like Miami Hurricane swag. You know what I'm saying, Dennis? It's amazing that Miami Hurricane fans don't even like Miami Hurricane swag. Like, Siri, where we do this at? Miami Hurricane fans don't even like Miami Hurricane swag. I brag different. I swag different. My wife Beyonce, I brag different. Like, serious. Oh, Matt Brown fired Manny. And then turned around and did the same thing and then gave Manny that same juice. And it's not just him, bro. These kids were on Twitter pleading for the fans to basically at least embrace them, and the fan base killed them. The fan base killed the players. What's the young man name that chose Maryland over Miami? Well, I'm going to root for Garcia. I'm going to root for Garcia. Oh, no, because, like I said, after that game, I heard some rumblings. I heard some rumblings that's what he envisioned when he came to Miami. He didn't go. See, people don't realize. I thought Rhett Lashley went after King. When he didn't go after King, Manny Diaz went after King. Yeah, T2, Terrence Lewis. All of a sudden, when he don't commit, we ain't want him anyway. He ain't that good. He ain't that good. You ain't want him anyway. Okay. All right. All right. I guess I'll open up. I wasn't going to do it, but I guess I'll open up the for anybody want to come in. And don't forget, if you want to donate to the PayPal. My birthday next week. I didn't get enough to get the PlayStation 5. So I keep my PlayStation 4 Pro. Got $15 donation from Norman again. Appreciate that. And another $10 from GE. I appreciate that, man. Thank you so much, fellas. Truly appreciate it, man. There's no ready, King. There's no way. Appreciate that, Cane Juice. There's no way King is gonna be ready, man. Oh, a lot of Cane's fans said that. That's why I say, man. It's the reason why. Like I said, and this is no knock on any other YouTuber that does videos. But there's a reason why I am 100% the realest Miami Hurricane video maker. Because I speak the truth, man. I'll tell you what happened. I'm going to tell you guys what happened. Perry's stock went up. He had teams calling him. His stock went up after the Cheez-It Bowl. His stock went up. because I would have to slap the shit out of Manny. If you want to see Manny get slapped, then you hire me as a defensive coordinator. And I slap his dad at the same time. I slap both of them. I really don't like his daddy. I don't really have too much against Manny, but I really don't like his daddy. He ain't towards ACL. His stock went up. And obviously, Manny told him that no matter how great you do, you're not going to. That's why he transferred. Obviously, Manny told him, no matter how great you do, no matter what you do, you will never play here. That's what Manny told him. That's what Manny told him. That's what Manny told him. No matter how great you are, no matter how great you did in that game, I don't care. My daddy don't want you to start here, so you'll never start here. That's why he left. And his stock went up after that game. And I bet you Rhett Lashley, I'm home drinking live. Rhett Lashley done drunk two bottles of this 1800. Rhett Lashley done drunk two whole bottles. He's sitting home like, what the fuck have I gotten myself into? That's what Rhett Lashley's saying right now. Manny Diaz's daddy had something against King. I mean, against Perry. Like, all right, you think about it. Just think about this right here. You know Dier got a torn ACL, right? This is the second time. The first time was a torn meniscus. This time is a torn ACL, right? You already know what you saw. You already know what he just did in this offense. With this offense, you see how this offense looked way better than it did all year, right? So De'Aaron King is more likely going to be out for at least week one, right? This is his best shot at being a starting quarterback at Miami. And he transfers. Why do you think he transferred? Because he got blackballed. Why else would he transfer? Why else would he transfer? Give me another reason why he would transfer. De'Aaron King is hurt, right? Right? De'Aaron King is hurt, right? He's not going to FAU or FIU. I can promise you that. He's not going to UCF. I can promise you that. He's not going. All right, y'all going to see. Y'all going to see where he's going. You're going to see. Hey, oh, that's the best statement all day, 100. Second string showed up. Manny's scared to face a true battle. He always saying that he wants a true competition. But he doesn't want a true competition. He's afraid of that. Manny Diaz doesn't like Mark Rick because he's just like Mark Rick. That's why he doesn't like him, because they're just alike. No, Perry not sitting out. No. I kind of have an idea where he's going, because when he was, I didn't know. I looked at my phone after everybody told me he's trying. I didn't know he's. Until I went live, he was transferring. And then I looked at my phone and I got a couple phone calls I had a couple text messages saying some of the reason why he's transferring from some good people. I have a very good idea where he's going, but I'm not saying anything because I wasn't told to say anything. You kind of warm there, Mr. Williams. You kind of warm there. You might be kind of warm there, man. He's not going to FAU. He's not going to FAU, Hurricane Kilo. I ain't gotta spill nothing. I ain't spilling nothing. I'm not giving out news for free no more. All these other guys get paid. I don't get paid. I ain't giving out news for free no more, man. But like I said, anybody who was in my chat tonight saw some of Perry people in my chat some of tonight and saw some of a few other players people in my Facebook chat tonight. Anybody who was in my Facebook chat tonight saw who was in my chat tonight. I'm just saying. Now, I'm not giving that up. You couldn't give me no amount of money because I was told to keep it on a hush hush. So what potential? I was just giving a couple of potentials. But like I said, when these other guys come on, it's PayPal me at. I don't know how I got that wrong. It's PayPal me at, not PayPal at. That's what it is. I don't think I'm gonna stay on too much longer, man. I think an hour's enough, man. OG, come in tonight, OG. I want you to let people know how you feel about social media, man. Come on in and join. You know I'm in mourning right now. OG. And like I said, it bugs me out because I talk to a lot of these kids' parents, man. I'm serious, man. I think what opened the floodgates up with me and the parents was the Bubba Baxter situation. Next thing you know, a lot of the parents start calling me. When Bubba Baxter and DJ Ivy got their lives threatened. And Bubba Baxter parents and DJ Ivy parents talked to me and called me and said they appreciate what I did. And then they started watching and they never see me talk bad about these kids. I don't know. Coach Coop in the building, man. I predicted departure yesterday. Fans told me I was stupid. Didn't want to leave. But I'm happy that he'll get a start somewhere. Who would want to be stuck number two guy when your entire college career with the most talent? Oh, my God. That's coming from Coach Coop. That's coming from Coach Coop. Hey, Coop, do me a favor, if you don't mind, if you have a few seconds. If you're too busy, I understand. But Coop, if you can, you don't have to show your face. But jump into this stream, man. And I didn't predict it. That's something I did not predict. I did not know. But when somebody said it, and I looked at my phone, and I looked at some text messages that from some people. I was like, and I think they didn't tell me. And I know somebody told me that they weren't going to tell me because they knew I was going to be, they already knew how I was going to feel. Coop got to be careful saying stuff like that though, man. Now, Coop fan base is a reasonable fan base, man. Yeah, this is why I love the guy so much, man. Because he doesn't politic. You won't hear another YouTuber say what he just said besides me. Yeah, you did predict it last year, Kenny Lauderdale. I remember you saying it last year. No, they don't want a true competition. And Manny Diaz will duck the question. He'll duck the question. They don't want a true competition. It's just sad, bro. What's up, Infamous?
What going on, big homie?
It's just like they don't want a true competition in Miami, bro. Manny Diaz's daddy runs that program, man.
Pretty much.
You know, for Coop to say that, like, I don't know, Coop don't go on nobody's channel. Like,
Coop hey, but the funny thing is, Coop predicted that Perry transferring, I want to say a couple of days ago because he said the video.
He said he did it yesterday. But
yeah,
but,
I watched but, the video but, when he did it.
But what he said to me was even that was more. Like he said he's tired of finishing second when he know he's the most talented on the. He's tired of knowing he's gonna be second when he knows he's the best player on the team. And I've never heard Coop don't take sides. That's not what Coop does. That's not what Coop does.
But Coop spoke the truth on that one.
And my thing is. I had somebody from Perry family hit me up today. I didn't even know because I hadn't checked my phone all day today, right?
Yeah.
So Kane's on. Let me see. So I just went live when I got off work, right? I went live as soon as I got off work, right?
Hey. Before you, I don't mean to cut you off, but before you start, I just want to let you know and let the people know I was on your Facebook Live when you was talking, and I seen the people that was in there with you when you was talking.
I appreciate that. Got a $50 donation. We got a $50 donation to the PayPal from Cane Juice, man.
Oh, also, I've been telling you in the chat, man, check your PayPal because I sent you a $10 donation.
I mentioned yours. You sent me 10. What's the name? Sent me I think 10 or 15. And then Kane, and then what's the name just sent me 50. Kane Juice said he was gonna see. He said, I'm gonna send you something since you said I watch Paul more than I watch you. I was just messing with him. We'll mess with each other back and forth because he said, Paul just broke some news, though.
I seen that earlier.
I was like, Paul.
When you was going to the liquor store, I seen that earlier.
I said, what news Paul broke? He laughing. He said, you stupid.
But then you predict that a week after the Oklahoma State-Miami game?
Talking about Perry leaving?
Nah, with Blake Baker getting demoted.
Oh, I didn't predict that. I said that's what happened because somebody told me that's what. See, I don't usually when I do something. Right? I try my best to make sure that I have facts, like from people who know people.
Yeah, before that's why I bring stated.
Yeah, I don't do like a lot of these guys. And hey, Kels, you got to wait a minute, Kel. I'm about to bring you back. I could do a prediction. I didn't predict this. Like you had to be. Damn, they're sent from God to predict this one. Coach Cooper, he a devout Christian, and God spoke in his ear because, like, I could not predict this, especially with King being hurt.
Hey, but I will say this, man. I'm like this too.
Oh, let me finish real quick.
Oh, like, go ahead.
But, yes, I was told after I got off my YouTube Live, I went and returned some phone calls. And I was told that Manny told Perry that he will not start next year.
Now, it's crazy you say that. Because I have a couple people, not just like you, I have a couple people that's also in Miami as well.
I was told this from somebody in Perry camp, though.
Like, and Oh no, this was one of my roommates that I went to class with down in Miami. And basically he told me, you know, Perry was forced out. And I'm like, what the fuck you mean? My bad.
You good.
And I'm like, nah, cause I'm like you right now, Zoe, but I'm like, I'm heated. Cause I'm very vocal about speaking how I feel. So I ain't mean to cuss, cause I know you trying to change it up. So that's
I'm not trying. I'm gonna be me. What I'm doing is I'm not going to let people. All right, I'm going to tell you, the biggest influence on my life this year when it came to this YouTube channel, period, point blank, is this girl right here. Okay?
Oh, yeah, Victoria, yeah. She
Bro, I was ready to quit. The last week before I was done.
I was in the chat. I was done. When old boy came in told my soul, you wasn't the first to break the Kobe Bryant story.
And it wasn't that he said that. It was the way. Hey, you gotta. You, I'm gonna let you stay on. But I got a special guest coming in, so I just want you to sit back and listen because this is the first time ever, like face to face. So we've done phone calls. We've never done this.
You ain't finna bring on who I'm thinking.
Yeah, my little brother. What's up, man?
Coach Coop.
Now, people like me and this guy have like a different love for each other. Like, I don't think people understand. Like, me and this guy have a different love for each other.
Oh yeah.
And T2Y I had to apologize to T2Y because I said the only one that's really that's on YouTube, that's the YouTube family, is Coach Coop, and people get upset with that. But Coach Coop is my little brother. Like, this is my guy. Like, we started basically together and we grew together, you know, and this is my guy. I mean, that's my brother.
Before we start, can I ask Coach Coop one thing?
Okay. Coach Coop said,
now I just want to know, Coach Coop, how you doing? And cause I know you was going through some issues early in the year, late last year. Just wanted, stay safe, and I hope, you know, be well, man.
Hey, I appreciate you asking, man. I'll be straight up and honest. I'm not going to take over the stream and start talking about a bunch of medical stuff, but I'm getting better. I'm on track. I'm still not perfect. I've not been doing live streams and stuff like that. I've got to go to like physical therapy 3 times a week, and I've still got other doctor's appointments and tests and stuff, but I'm getting on track.
You do see us pray for you almost every week, right? Because
I appreciate it, man. It's been tough. I ain't going to lie. I've been sick for like 4 months. Struggle, dude.
And I told people, I said, have you talked to him? I said, if I'm not talking to Coop, Coop is something wrong. So I said, we just going to pray for Coop. We're going to keep praying for Coop, and Coop will be back.
So let's not make this about you, though. Let's talk about Perry a little bit.
I like what you said, dude. That's
a video, honestly, I didn't want to make, but I had a gut feeling yesterday. And I've been saying this. I'm not saying it to tell people I told you so. It was just a prediction. I didn't have somebody call me up. I didn't have any kind of inside sources. I didn't know.
But anything. You do have inside sources.
Well, I mean, I talked to a couple people, but I just don't like being that guy. Like, I don't put it out there. But I was like, I got a gut feeling. It just, everything lines up. It makes sense. So I put that video out late last night on the 6th and woke up to... You wouldn't believe, actually, you probably would. I was going to say, most people wouldn't believe the amount of DMs I woke up to of people just telling me I'm so stupid and they can't believe that I would say that and that I'm a Perry hater and all this stuff. It was literally just a prediction because I felt like everything lined up and it made sense that he was going to hit the portal. And I did nothing but compliment him the entire video. You know that I've been an Nkosi Perry fan from day one.
My first video.
Was about Nkosi Perry because I loved him so much.
Matter of fact, I could tell your first video because I talked about Perry, but your first video was it was basically telling Mark Richt to bring him back into the fold.
Yeah, because I love Nkosi Perry. And the thing is I don't I don't blame him at all for wanting to leave. Honestly, I hate it for him, but I don't blame him at all for wanting to leave because, who, like I said, who wants to be the number two guy? Who wants to ride the bench when you have the talent that Nakosi Perry has? I like De'Aaron King as a well-rounded overall quarterback, but I actually prefer Nakosi Perry's arm. And I hate it that we don't get to see him with a couple of years under his belt working with Rhett Lashley. So it does kind of suck. But I put the scenario out there in my video. Why would – just think about it. Why would he come start against, let's say, Alabama, and then he plays against App State? But then let's say week three rolls around for Michigan State and – or actually, let me check the schedule, make sure I'm not talking out of my booty here. Yeah, Michigan State week three, they say, all right, King is all clear. He's ready to go. And then they just make Perry ride the bench again for the rest of the season. I'd be out too, honestly. You know,
I was told – I did a Facebook chat today, and I had a few of his people in my chat too. But I didn't know. I work from 5 to 5. I didn't even check my phone all day today. I'm serious. I was inside of a 49-foot vessel welding all day. I ate my lunch inside the pipe. See, I didn't come out my pipe. So when I went live, I went live as soon as I got off work just to mess with T2Y. But tell everybody, I told him he got me bullied by Chris. But I told everybody to follow him watching his live streams on the college football playoffs. Mm-hmm. Right? Then somebody said Perry transferred. He put a transfer report. I said, no, he didn't. So I go look at my phone. And I got like 20 missed text messages. And someone that I know that's like this, him and Perry, like, you know, they're basically, Manny Diaz told him, you have no future here.
He would never be the starter here because I think that even next year, people were like, well, then he's definitely going to take over. Honestly, I think that at that point, they would still end up starting TVD or Garcia over him. And I'm not saying I agree with that, but I'm saying that's what I personally think would happen.
That's basically what was told to him by Manny Diaz, not by Rhett Lashley, because Rhett wanted him. And I was also told that Rhett did not go after De'Aaron King.
I can see that with the type of offense that Lashley runs, that he could actually prefer Perry. Yeah, definitely.
And like I said, and the only reason I say stuff like this is because, and I'm glad Infamous One was in my chat and my YouTube because he's seen the people that was in there. He's seen people that's in there that know Perry and DJ Ivy and Nasty Ness, I guess the reason why, just like you get the same calls, because I know some calls that you've got for some people we've talked offline. Mm-hmm. When you don't bash kids, the parents tend to, especially on this platform, the parents tend to reach out to you and say thank you.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
So I get a lot of the parents reaching out to me, you know, saying thank you for not letting them kill our kids, and it's been like that for a long time, and actually. I never did it, but and I give Coop credit. Coop helped soften my image because I watch. I'm just being honest. I watch what Coop, even though I'm me, but I watch how Coop do things, and I tell everybody Coop does things different than anybody. Like his energy is just different from everybody's. He does what he feels, but he does it in a positive way. He gives back to the charity. He gives back to the St. Jude's. He gives back. And that's what I do a different way, but I give back. And that's why I respect Coop so much, because his donations don't go to Coop. His donations go to everybody else.
But see, that's what I tell people to do is just that. That's just how honestly I am in my day-to-day life. And see the way you act, that's how you carry yourself in your day-to-day life. Just be yourself. And then what you do is then that, in return, attracts like-minded people that are like you. So it's kind of fun to hang out with people that like you, want to be around you. And if you're yourself, you don't have to pretend like you're something else when you're in front of the camera and online and on YouTube and stuff. So,
and I think that's why so many people get mad at, like, especially other YouTubers, is because I keep bringing your name on. Like he doesn't even live in Miami. I said the same thing his first year. I said the same thing his first year. He don't go to no. I said the same shit his first year. I said his first year, me and him got in an argument. I said the same. I said, but you only can use that narrative for so long when you see how positive somebody is. That narrative goes this far. It goes this far. So when you see how positive Coop is, you can't say nothing. You can't say anything. You can't say anything. Everybody, like, everybody loves Raymond. Everybody loves Coop, man. You have to, because he's just a good guy.
No, I'm just trying to get along with everybody and just have fun talking college football, man. That's it. I like drama, but it's got to be revolving around football. If it's football drama, I'll talk about it all day long.
I'm getting away from it. I've pushed myself further and further away from it. I block people. If we're not talking facts, I don't even want to hear it.
Yeah.
But I engage. I think my problem is sometimes I engage in a chat too much. But if you're not talking facts, if you're not talking facts, then there's no reason for me to even engage in a conversation with you. I'm not going to do that, because you're just speaking. Like, I've told people, I've asked people. And I wanted Manny. I was one of the biggest advocates for Manny.
Same here.
In 5 years, how many players has he developed?
Hey, I'm going to tell you like this. To answer that question for you, when the name pop up in my head, I either hit you up on Facebook or I see it in the chat on here.
That's it. In 5 years, like, we talk about developing players. And people got mad at me because I put something out about transfer. We defend more on transfer portal players than developing players. Well, Lonzo, you can't say that, because you know we yes I can, because we do. We have to develop our kids.
But that's a fair statement, because it seems like every transfer portal player that Manny has gotten has started or has played over somebody that's been there, that's done put in the work, that shows they're committed and ready to step up and want to be a Hurricane.
Well,
Victoria says Coop has the perfect commentating voice.
I don't know about that. Everybody says I've got this real heavy redneck southern accent, and I don't notice it because I live in Tennessee, so everybody talks like this. But I have heard, you know, that it won some award in a couple years ago for like sexiest voice in America, right? Like sexiest accent. So I'm just saying.
So cool. You got, don't take your shirt off, Coop.
I've done that in multiple videos. We're not gonna go there. I'm gonna stop there.
Oh man, but what was you about to say, man?
I was gonna say it's crazy though, because if you think about it, even just over the last few years when we're talking about transfer portal stuff, it's a tough thing to talk about, because I actually do agree with the whole we need to focus on developing a lot of our players instead of band-aids and pulling in transfer portal players, because even though a lot of them have come in and had an immediate impact, long-term, it's not going to work for us. And what sucks, though, or what's weird about it, is that even just over the last few years, if you think about it, college football has really evolved with the transfer portal and everything. So it's tough, because it's hard to fault coaches or players, either one, when it comes to the transfer portal, because it's a tool that's available to them. And if they don't use it, other teams are going to. So it's really tough. And it's going to be interesting when they start being able to players can make money off of their likeness and stuff. That's going to add another factor in. So to be honest with you, I'm kind of nervous where college football in general is going in the future, I guess is what I'm trying to say, because it's starting to evolve, you know, all these different rules with targeting and all that, the transfer portal, the benefiting off likeness stuff. So over the next few years, college football could get really interesting, and potentially not in a good way. I'm not trying to be a negative Nancy here. I'm just putting it out there.
Oh no, see, what I don't like about the way Miami uses it, is Miami uses it to build the program. It's not like they're trying to fill specific spots. They'll take any good transfer portal player, no matter what spot, instead of developing that. And that's what scares me with Miami. Like, if you look at a team like even Oklahoma, they'll take it as a need basis while they're developing players. We get these 1 year players and they leave, and we have to get another 1 year player to relieve that player.
Yeah, and if you notice, I mean, pretty much every, especially like skill position players, QBs and wide receivers and stuff, as soon as like a 4 or 5-star guy hits the portal, it's breaking news on every Miami Hurricane site that we need to go after that guy.
And what does that tell? And I told him, And like I said, even, like I said on my Facebook Live, and some of the parents were saying that it makes the locker, it divides the locker room. You know, when Brevin Jordan said that Tate Martell was the best quarterback in the locker room. Remember that year he said that?
Yeah.
When he said that, how do you – and then Malik Rozier come out and said that Perry was the best. But when Brevin Jordan said that, how do you think that made Perry or Malik or anybody else on that – Jaren Williams, how do you think they made those three guys feel?
Yeah.
For you to come out and say that because he's your friend.
So what do you think though? Back on the Perry stuff, I'm asking you and everybody in the chat because there's 145 people in here. So let's see some participation. Where do you think potentially? It doesn't even have to be a specific school necessarily, but where do you think Nikosi Perry could potentially end up? As far as like, do you think he could start at another Power Five school? Or I'll open up with it if I'm going to ask. I think that. And see, I'm bringing in personal stuff to it, but we all know that he has a young daughter and girlfriend. They live in Florida, South Florida. Mm-hmm. I think that he would try to stay in Florida within the state if he goes somewhere.
I can't answer the question because I was basically given a couple of schools, so it would be unfair.
I got you. Fair enough.
To answer, it would be unfair.
I
could be wrong.
But. I got one, and this is from a couple sources. Here where I stay at, I can't mention where I stay at because where I stay at, I actually coach at one of the high schools, but there is a big, big rumor going around that school that
nobody likes.
That Perry might end up at UF.
I'm saying that
because it's a couple of coaches here where I stay at has a lot of connects to not only Ocala Vanguard, but they also are connected in good with UF.
I can say this. UF reached out to him last year. I can't say that.
And I mean, UF
reached out to him before he even decided to go to Miami recruiting.
No, I'm talking about like when everything was going down and the bad stuff, they reached out to his family. Is what I'm saying. They reached out.
Either way, wherever he goes, I just want it to be known that I'll be rooting for him no matter what. The only way I would root against whatever team he's playing for is if they ended up playing Miami. But otherwise, I want him to do well, and I think that there's a lot of schools that he could potentially start at and really excel no matter what school it is. But I'm looking at what everybody in the chat, like where do you think he could
They got UAB. Somebody got Syracuse. Got Oklahoma, Texas. I can say this right here. I said he's not going to FAMU. He's not going that low. That's not happening. You could take that out of that one. I said it. I'm dead serious, Cool. As bad as they did him, whoever he goes to, if they play against Miami, I'm rooting for him.
Fair enough. I completely understand.
I'm rooting for him. He's not going to Jackson State. Take all the Division I AA schools out of it.
In my opinion, for Perry, I think the play against Miami this year or this year coming up, the perfect fit for Nikosi Perry would be Virginia Tech.
That's my opinion. They would block that though.
He's in the transfer portal. But why would they block it?
They'll block it. Because they don't want to play against them. Would you?
Wayne Smith said, "Stop throwing shots at my school, fam." You.
I love Florida A&M, but y'all ain't got no money. And who gonna go play in that stadium, man? Y'all got a 12,000 seat stadium, man.
The biggest thing, though, honestly, because I mean, I made another video this afternoon after I made that prediction last night. The biggest thing, though, that I've been saying to Canes fans is I just don't want to see any Nikosi Perry slander, because after everything he's been through at the University of Miami and the crappy situations and spots that he's been put in and been expected to perform and then still turned around and thrown on the bench, I don't want to see anybody bad-mouthing him, period. Because I had some people – it takes a lot for me to ban people on my channel. You guys know that. But I had some people in my comment section bashing him, saying that they can't believe that he screwed Miami because he was the next guy up with the most experience and he's leaving the university hanging and all this crazy stuff. I don't want to see any of that nonsense on social media or anybody else's channel. I'm not the social media police, but I just think that's the stupidest thing I've ever heard. After all the work and effort and stuff that he's put in, he's got the U literally tatted on his forearm. Yep. I don't want to see anybody talking smack about him when he was going to be the second man up for his entire career at Miami. I don't blame him one bit for leaving.
I've blocked three people tonight already. No, four Same people tonight already. I'm not with it. It's not happening. I don't care. You'll be blocked. I'm not. Listen, the guy, and this is for me talking to parents. Like I said, I know you talk to parents who coach Coop, and what I did in the chat tonight was I was talking to some – I had some parents in, and we were talking about some American football players, and they were talking about, like, the Twitter stuff that went down tonight. Mm-hmm. I mean, after the game. And it was like the kids were so heartbroken at how bad they get treated by their fan base. And these kids, they don't understand that these are still kids. Like, I get emotional. You get a – so you can imagine these kids, like, they go out there and they put it all on the line to get beat up by the fan base.
Yeah, because I'm a lot of times very critical of the team in general, coaching staff and players and whatnot. But number one, I never tag players. If I do tag a player, it's because I'm congratulating them for something, like Borgalis winning the award and stuff today. Like, I might tag them to be like, congrats, bro. That's
awesome. Guess what? You know,
stuff like that. But
and we didn't develop him. Transfer portal.
True, yeah. That's a good point. But I mean, at the end of the day, their family, like, they chose to go to the University of Miami. I want them to exceed and excel in everything that they do. And that's why I made it a big point in my video when people said that I was knocking Perry and stuff. Like I said, I did nothing but compliment him. The reason why I said he should transfer, and I think he's going to transfer, honest to goodness, think about it, is because I want the best for him. If he's going to be able to provide for his family, assuming that, you know, I mean, he could still get his degree and everything, but if he wants to be a multimillionaire and go to the NFL, he was going to have to transfer and go somewhere else. So it just made sense.
And another thing is his stock rose a lot. A lot of teams contacted him after that. And people bug me out because I'm sitting there, so you're just going to say King didn't show you nothing. King did not show me anything close to what Perry showed me in 2.5 quarters. I'm not knocking King, but if you look at every throw, the back shoulder throw, the post run, like, Perry literally threw players open. With King, it was always a 50-50 ball. Like either you have to out-jump. Perry in that Oklahoma State game, he threw receivers open. The ball was there before they could turn around.
Yeah, I mean, he throws a beautiful pass.
That one to Cam Harris, oh my, I was like, how did he get that in there?
Yeah, that one to Cam Harris was nice.
That's what I'm saying. He's going to tear it up when he transfers and lands somewhere, for sure.
And I said this right here. I said this too, Coach Coop, after that game. You know what I said?
What?
I said, Miami Hurricane fans did not deserve to win that game. I'm glad those receivers dropped their ball.
Fair enough.
They did not deserve to watch him win because all they're going to do is bash him next year. So they didn't deserve it. And I'm just being – I have to be myself. I have to be real. And to watch these people kill this kid the way they did, and then you cheer for him, and then he's being disrespectful or killing you by leaving – but you wanted him gone.
Yep, that's what I'm saying. That's why I finally had to drop the ban hammer on some of these people, because I couldn't do it. I couldn't deal with it.
That's crazy.
It's almost like a love and hate relationship. A love to hate me relationship. You love it when I'm doing. You love it when I'm doing good, but you hate me when I'm when I start messing up.
Well, my thing is, you have to be given a chance to mess up. Like you think about
but
it.
Hold on for a second.
Just what I'm saying, real quick. Remember last year, right? He was inaccurate, right? With all the receivers that were dropping balls, he's inaccurate. But when they were dropping King's balls this year, the receivers are just dropping balls. You see what I'm saying? I mean, these are the same receivers that were dropping balls last year for Perry.
And yeah, and see, I see that's exactly the kind of talk that I'm talking about as far as like, see, I don't consider the way that you're saying that. You're not hating on De'Aaron King. You're just kind of critiquing some things. A lot of the stuff with Perry was hate, the things that people were saying and doing. And it blows my mind.
I watched players like everybody was Lorenzo Lingard. And I like Killer Cam better because his running style. So I don't just go for the most popular player all the time. That's just not who I am. And with King, it wasn't about that. If he could make those throws, but even a quick slant across the middle, all of his got batted down. That's why they didn't throw him. And so, Perry got batted down year one or two, but they can't throw them at all with King, and that's because of his height. It's not that I'm hating on him. If you look at a lot of the balls he throw, he jumps up and throw them off one leg.
I hate it because a lot of it's bad timing. Like, I wish that we could have had he's not perfect. There's still a lot of improvements that need to be made, but I wish we could have had Rhett Lashley and Perry together earlier.
I think if Rhett Lashley would have had his – if it was Rhett Lashley's choice, Perry would have started this year. And like I said, you said it. The offense looked like it was tailor-made. But guess what? That same offense is the same offense that Perry ran in high school. The exact same offense. The exact same offense that broke every Dante Culpepper record. The exact same offense.
Hey, so, y'all want to hear something crazy?
Go for it.
I actually got a chance to watch Perry in high school when he came here to Lakeland, and he played. He was in the state playoffs, and they played against Lake Gibson here in Lakeland. Now, when I tell you, them coaches at Lake Gibson did not know what – they didn't have an answer for Perry. It's like he was everywhere. And it's like I'm watching – thinking about from then till now, and it's like for Manny or Mark Richt not to get him a fair chance, and it's like, bro, y'all really, like, I don't get it. I mean, I get it, but I don't get it.
Oh, I don't get it, but at the same time, this is why I'm glad Coop came on, and this was not planned.
No.
Everybody has been trying to get me to collab with Coop. And like I told y'all, we was going to do some collaborations this year. We had planned on it, and then some things happened.
Yeah, 2020 got crazy for a lot of people, though. So
I can guarantee you me and Coop will do some collabs next year. I can guarantee you.
I'm down to link up for sure. This one got me too worked up and heated between fans and just all the talk and stuff with all this. So I had to hop on and say something.
And it's amazing because like I said, me and Coop started. I started a year before Coop, and Coop taught me. Coop and Cole Perry walked me through so much stuff when it came to the technical side. And Coop built my computer for me. My computer's already good, but he made it, and I got it back. Coop cost me $1,000, but.
I mean, that it's worth it though. You would have spent more to get something else. So
yeah, but I mean, it was like cool. Like he walked me through so much stuff, and it's like we started this together. And this is why I was telling people like when I started doing post game videos, I'm gonna do post game videos. And Coop was like, okay, well, I'll do live stream. I'm like, damn it,
I got a question for both of y'all.
You like the siren too, right?
Yeah,
my,
I mean,
my name, love it, man.
Bro, it was like I said I'm gonna do the post game. I want to do post game. Get up in there, and Coop said, you know what, I'm gonna do live streams. I said, okay, but he done outsmarted me again, and then he give out the links and the siren and you know the skirt thing. I'm not doing the skirt.
Please though, I'm ready to retire the trash can. I don't want to do any more streams from inside the garbage can because that wasn't a brand new one I went and bought from Walmart. I literally pulled the garbage bags out of it outside, dropped them, brought it in here, and got in it. There was probably bugs in it and all kinds of nasty stuff.
I'm sorry, bro, but I wouldn't have made that bet. I ain't wearing no skirt.
Listen, I do what it takes, man, to entertain. Whatever it takes to get the fans laughing.
This is what I say is so different about Coop. Like, all right, I don't know if you guys listen to URL. But you have this guy by the name of Pat State, and he's a white battle rapper. His name is Pat State, and everybody's scared to battle him because he's so different. He's so different, and his wordplay is different, and he comes on the top of his head, and people just be like, "God dang!" It's like you Coop. The reason why Coop is so successful is because he's so different. The same way you say you wouldn't do that. And I wouldn't do that. Is the reason why Coop had 15,000 subscribers. Is the reason why Coop keeps 500, 600, 700 in his live stream. Is the reason why Coop, you know what I'm saying? It's because his entertainment level is second to none. He knows how to entertain. And that's and he does it. If you can't laugh at yourself, like he does it.
Oh, dude, you can't take me seriously. Like, yeah, I mean, unless we're talking like stats or you know, a prediction video as far as stuff like that. Yeah, otherwise, you can't take me seriously because I'm always just goofing off, man. I'm here to have fun and talk football and just enjoy hanging out with friends and family. Because I always say if I'm not having fun doing something, why the heck am I even doing it? And I apply that to my job, to everything that I do in life. Period. The one question I have though, the one thing that still kind of just has me confused is y'all act like you had never seen a naked man in the bathtub covered in Cheez-Its. Like, what the heck, man? Come on.
I've never seen a naked man.
That picture was shared over 100,000 times.
I'm going to keep it a buck with you. I have never seen a naked man in Cheez-Its.
You have now, though, right?
Yeah, I have now.
Okay, good deal.
Nah.
You ain't seen the video?
I'm glad I can check that box.
You know what? You got a point. Because soon I see you in a dress, I'm like, I'm not watching this.
You still watched it. Because I watched it and died. I said, Coop is crazy. Coop is crazy.
Kane's Football even commented on it. And they said, that's a lot of Cheez-Its. And I was like, oh, man, we've made it now.
He does. Listen, this is what makes Coop, like, great. Like, this is what makes him a legend in it. Because, like, he does stuff. You know the rapper The Baby from Charlotte?
Oh yeah.
He wore a diaper. It got him publicized. He got one of the biggest record deals in hip hop right now.
Yeah, so cool. I don't care if it entertains the fans, man, I'm happy. I'm all about it.
And that's what you do. You entertain. I tell you what. And you know I'll chime in. I'm in every live stream. I'm in every one of your game days. I'm in all of them. I'm because like the one you said when I didn't even know I was in there and you said something about, you know what I'm saying, what made you start doing videos, you mentioned my name and I was like,
yeah, it was you. I used to be over at my now wife, then girlfriend's house, and after every game, whenever you were posting videos, I'd break out my laptop on the kitchen table and I'd watch them.
And I never knew that. Yep, I never knew that. And he was like, somebody asked me and I'm going to answer it. And I'm in the chat and I'm like, somebody asked something. Ask something or something. I didn't say nothing. Then you mentioned my name. I was like, what?
Yeah, I just hate it. 2020, I didn't honestly get to do what I wanted to. I'm telling you, I had stuff. I've got like fog machines that were going to shoot smoke out and mics were going to drop from the ceiling. Like 2021 is going to be crazy. As long as I'm healthy and ready to rock, 2021 is going to be something else, man.
Can I get some mic drops from the ceilings and fall?
We're going to do crazy stuff, man.
I mean, I can tell you this here. I'm going to be in that stream key sometime. I can promise you that. I'm gonna be in. I got to have you over here sometimes though, man. I got to, because like you a common figure. Like you're like, I was mad the whole video until you came on.
Hey, well, I get
to see my brother.
I gotta ask somebody a question real quick though. Sadrak in your chat, Ahmad says, "I saw Coop in that cheerleading outfit." I got one question for him. All right.
Did you like what you saw?
I'm just asking. I got one guy that donates every week to me, Black Hollywood. God. Every time I rock the chain, he says, "Coop, you look sexy, bro," and he donates $10.
Coop, can you do that again? Lord. Hey, Coop, you gotta do that one again. I like the way you did. You gotta do that one again, Coop.
Well, I'm waiting for his response. I don't know if he left you. You
have to ask him again. Because he responded. Everybody laughing.
I'm looking to see if he responds.
Oh my God!
No, I'm sorry, man. You lost my viewers. That's my bad, man.
I'm dying. How you hit the zone one? Do that again, Coop.
There he is. All right. Anyways, we gotta get back on Perry. We're talking too much about him.
Oh my God! That was that.
With Zoe being on and with you being on, Coop, I got a question for you.
All right, hit me.
Now that Perry's in the transfer portal, Perry ain't coming back to Miami. So let's just hypothetically, this is me hypothetically speaking. Say Miami get down in the game. They down 2 touchdowns, 14 points. Mm-hmm. And given with Perry's track record, every time Miami is down 7, 14, however many points, they like to bring Perry in to be the comeback kid, be the savior for them. Right. So, with Perry being gone and Miami being down however many points, does that expose Manny Diaz, or do the board of trustees just say, okay, you know what, we riding with Manny, let him do his thing?
This is Manny's. I'm gonna tell you this here. What just happened today with Perry, and it's not just the board of trustees. It's a lot of alumni and it's a lot of boosters. What got out today with Perry and why Perry left? If I can almost guarantee you, if Manny don't win 10 games next year, he's gone. They're not going to continue to put up with this. They're not. You can't keep blaming. Like I say, the defense that's being called is the defense that was being called. Only difference is with younger players. Okay? So you won't fire Blake Baker, which I don't think Blake Baker needs to be fired, because I think it's Manny called. Like, Manny said he called him plays and then tried to backtrack a little bit. So look at his interview. He said he's calling plays. Okay? So you are the head guy in charge. You haven't developed any players in 5 years. And I don't want to hear he's only been a head coach for 2 years, because he was over the defense for 3. Okay. So you haven't developed any players in 5 years. Our linebackers regressed under you, and you was the linebacker coach. I'm not telling lies. Shaq got fat, started eating cheeseburgers, going to McDonald's and wearing suits and stuff. Okay. They regressed. Let's just be honest, they regressed under you. So we haven't developed players. We go to the transfer portal. And we're not really winning anything. They're not going. And with Perry leaving, I'm gonna let Coop answer. With Perry leaving, no matter what reason he left, if you do not win next year, they're not going to give you, oh, you had a freshman quarterback, because you had a quarterback that you let walk out the door. They're not going to let you use that excuse. Go ahead, Coach.
I'm going to be honest. I'm actually in a little bit of a different position, not because I agree with it, but with what I think would happen. I actually think that, man, I hate to say this, but I just, that's how I feel about it. I think that even if Manny had a losing year next year, I think that he would be fine. I think he'd still be here. I think that 2020 even though there were a lot of mistakes made and fans are rioting about some, you know, other various things like Blake Baker's defense and whatnot, and some questionable decisions for Manny Diaz and with developing players, like you mentioned, and some other things, I still think a lot of coaches in college football in general are going to get a pass for 2020 because it's going to be labeled as the COVID season. All things considered, we still had a better season than we had record-wise in 2019. We're going to have a top 10 recruiting class. I think that even if he loses next season, that he would still be around. I think Manny, honestly, there would be people calling for his head. There would be some higher ups that would be really upset and mad about it. And a lot of former players have already been voicing their opinion about some things. Me personally, I think regardless, Manny is safe. I guess this would be year three, but I mean 3 to 5 years.
I think he's on a chopping block. But I mean that's all. I'm not saying anything factual.
Right. Yeah. It's all just hypothetical. No. Nobody has to agree with me, or nobody has to agree with you, or anybody else. It's just we're just chit chatting. We're talking about what we think.
I'm gonna ask you a question with this top 10 recruiting class right now. Mm-hmm. We've only had one recruiting class outside of the top 25 since Manny's been here, and I think that was 2008. Yeah. Even with a top 10 recruiting class this year, does it? I feel like we have 2-star coaches coaching 4 and 5-star players.
What I hate is, I guess we kind of knew what we were getting into it, and when I say we, I guess. I say fans. A lot of people did want Manny Diaz. Like you said, you did. I did.
I want him.
He wants to win. I mean, his job depends on it.
I don't
You don't think so?
No. I'm not saying he don't want to win. What I'm saying is we all can see with a naked eye that Perry was better than Jaren Williams and Malik Rozier. We all see them with a naked eye. So if you want to win, you play the best players. We all saw how great Russo was. What took you so long to put him in?
I mean, I don't have an answer.
Yeah. You see what I'm saying? So that's why I say I'm conflicted. Do you really want to win? Or are you so stubborn and stuck in your ways that you want to win just your way? Because the thing about a Bill Belichick, because if you think Bill Belichick, even Nick Saban was stubborn for years until he said, you know what, I'm tired of Texas A&M coming in, Manziel coming in scoring 70 points, and we only can score 20. So he went and hired Lane Kiffin, and he went and got a dual threat quarterback so they can open offense up. He changed his mindset, said we can't do this. I think Manny is so stubborn in his own way, and not just that, it seemed like he got lazy Every year as a defensive coordinator, he was jumping with the players, chest to chest, you know. This year he got fat. I don't even know if he could jump 2 feet off the ground.
Well, and I hate it too because this is not an excuse. Don't get me wrong. But we do have a guy who is only going into his third year of ever being a head coach. Now, again, that's not an excuse.
Oh, yeah.
I'm just saying that I don't know. I think he's safe. I think he's safe though, just about no matter what happens. Unless we lose, like, 8 or 9 games, I think that he's safe.
And I can't disagree with that. Believe, I cannot disagree. Like I said, I have nobody telling me that Manny's fired. So I cannot disagree with you at all.
And like I said, right now I'm not taking a side. It's not a prediction. It's not me saying I agree or disagree with it. It's just my opinion. It's just how I feel.
I just wish.
But honestly. And I'm taking this comment from Young Jedi Kane.
Young Jedi?
He
in the chat. When
Young Jedi said what he said on the one vid you did, I can't completely agree with Young Jedi. And I'm just noting that I'm 39 years old. Young Jedi's what, 13, 14?
Yep.
But when you speak facts, I'm with you when you're right. And when he said it, I started watching Manny. I started watching his press conferences. Then I watched his post-game press conferences. Manny is right now, he's not only stubborn, but he's prideful. And Manny got the mindset of oh, well, I brought the University of Miami back to its glory days, and I ain't really need that much help. So if I can do it, anybody else can do it. But, and I mean, that's it, and you can see it. It's, that's his mindset.
Well, I mean, and they,
hey, the infamous one. Can you do me a favor? I'm gonna do like 10 more minutes. Let me have these last 10 with my brother. Let me have these last, because I'm only gonna do like 10 more. I was only gonna be on for an hour.
I didn't mean to jump on and take.
No. I want to do these last 10 with you. Because, like I said, this is years 6 and 7 for us. You know what I'm saying? I want to do a little New Year's. Even though you don't drink, I'm gonna do a little New Year's toast, man. And
no, I'm drinking my what I call my Metapoopsil. It's actually Metamucil to help you poop, you know.
I got you on it. Cheers. I ain't kicking you out, but I'm just going. I want to talk to my brother for these last 10 minutes, and I'll catch you on the next chat.
But no. And I wanted to mention too with that we were talking about. Just imagine too, it would be. I mean, it could happen. It could, but I'm just saying we just brought in Lashley in 2020, a new offensive coordinator. There's going to be a lot of people on the defensive side of the ball that are going to be replaced for multiple reasons. Then if they were to turn around in 2021, we have a mediocre season, and then they let Manny go, a lot of other guys are then also going to have to be replaced. And then next thing you know, we're completely rebuilding again. And again, I'm not giving an opinion on where I stand with any of that yet. But I'm just saying, I think that for a lot of people, they don't want to go through all of that again. Like they would wait and still ride it out with Manny and let him replace some other positions and whatnot before they would can him and then rebuild a bunch more.
I can see that. Like I said, the main problem. Yep, this is a Victoria's belt. This is not my belt. This belt belonged to Victoria. She won it this year. This is her belt, not mine. So she'll be getting it. I'm going to her college graduation, and I'll give it to her there.
What do you guys think in the chat? I want to see as much participation as possible. There's almost 150 people in here. If Miami has a, I mean, what do we say? What do we consider? We go.
I ain't gonna lie. You did a Charles Farms to me tonight. You talked me off the ledge a little bit. Because I said, if he don't win 10 games, I want him fired.
Yeah, and I said, and I'm not saying that I'm okay with him.
No. Him, you told me off the ledge a little bit. I'm saying you told me off the ledge a little bit. Sometimes you need that. Sometimes you need somebody to say, just calm down a little bit.
So my question to the chat was, if we have a mediocre 2021, it realistically, could Manny Diaz be gone? It's super early. Just humor me for a minute. It's just an opinion. We're just hypothetical, just guessing. I'm not going to write it down and take notes and screenshot it and call you out at the end of the 2021 season. Because if we have a mediocre season, year three, Manny Diaz, after what we did in 2019 and then improving into 2020 after the COVID season, would he be realistically on the chopping block? Would they actually get rid of him?
I think with as many players leave early because of him, I don't know.
I don't think so. I don't think so.
Just think about it. If say we have a pretty good season, but we lose a whole bunch of guys again because they're leaving. They leave. I've never seen players leave so fast to jump to the NFL to get away from Miami. Like, I mean, they're getting 4th, 5th round picks. Like they're going to the top. And
just don't mistake it as me trying to like talk negative about Manny Diaz.
Oh, no.
Obviously, I'd prefer him to succeed and us go. I don't know, you know. I know we opened with Alabama, but yeah, it'd be awesome if we went undefeated or something and went to the playoffs. All that. If Manny succeeds, that means that Miami is succeeding. That means our recruiting is doing well. That means all of our players are doing well, which helps them get to the next level. I want nothing but success. So I'm just putting it out there.
I could tell you this here, with him only having one win off of a bye week, if we go get murdered in Atlanta next year because we don't have a quarterback, that's going to hurt him. If we get murdered in Atlanta next year on national TV because we don't have a quarterback, let's say it's one of those clips in store, which could probably be worse as good as Alabama is right now. But if we, I mean, just look at what North Carolina did to us this year.
I'm not going to lie. I'm scared of Alabama, at least right now. January 7th, 2021, I'm terrified of Alabama.
Yeah, and I'll be there. So we're going to do a collab there.
I'm bringing my father-in-law because he's a huge Alabama fan. So hey, we can all sit. That might be a mistake on my.
We can all sit. We'll do it before the game. No post game video. No post game.
I'm out. I'm getting in the car. See you later. Post
game. But if they do us worse than, just imagine what North Carolina did to us this year with their talent. If we get anything close to that week one, and the main reason is because we don't have a quarterback. See, Rhett basically gave Rhett Lashley a free pass. Is what happened. Rhett has a free pass this year.
I mean, literally, then all you have to say is, well, we started a new guy at quarterback. Yeah, but potentially the number one or number two team in the
they're
country.
Not going to give him that excuse, though, because you had a guy that you kicked out.
Fair. Fair.
They're not going to get that. That would say that could give Rhett Lashley a pass, but it won't give Manny a pass because everybody know Manny wanted him gone. So that's what I'm saying. So if you go get throttled by Alabama, right, and you win the rest of your games, you lose one more game, you safe. But if you take two or three beatings next year, I don't know if you're safe, especially and then to lose another bowl game because what we at 10 and 11 in a row now?
It's
bowl losses?
Yeah.
No, we ain't lost 11 in a row. I think
We won in 2016.
We won against West Virginia.
Yeah, at Camping World Stadium.
Yeah. Incidentally. As a matter of fact,
Don says his freshman going to start for Alabama at quarterback. I think it'll be Tyler Van Dyke is who will probably start.
Yeah, I don't think people think King tore his meniscus 2 years ago.
Same.
He tore his ACL this year. That's hard to come back, especially his style of play.
Yeah, and I mean you got to come back from that both physically and mentally from an injury like that. So I think that against Alabama, it would probably be TBD. I know everybody's hyped on Jake Garcia, but you've got to have that adjustment from the high school to the college level. TBD was here in 2020. So, you know, he's been in the practices and stuff. I know he didn't really get any game time experience, but.
Does that mean anything to Manny, though? Garcia's a Manny's guy. Manny's been going after him.
Yeah, I mean, I know that Lashley likes TVD a lot. Obviously, he probably likes Garcia a lot, but he's not been on campus, you know, and got to practice or anything.
But he wanted Perry.
Yeah.
Lashley wanted. You could see when as soon as Perry came in, the whole playbook changed. We didn't see that playbook all year.
Because I always liked people complained about Perry's accuracy. But I liked, honestly, that he was willing to sling it. I always say, but if somebody would look like they were open downfield, Perry is going to send it. He's going to put it up there and expect his guy to make a play on the ball. And he wasn't afraid to do that. So with that, throwing more deep balls and throwing more passes does come usually, you know, some extra interceptions and maybe a little lower completion percentage. But like I said, he could throw a beautiful pass, and he wasn't afraid to send it.
See, last year it was his accuracy, and this year it was King's players are dropping balls. And I kept the same players that played with Perry last year that were dropping balls. So a lot of that has to do – remember, I think Cager had like 20-something drops. Hey, Kels, you got to get back in another night, Kels. You're going to – I think
What's the point of recruiting a QB if you're scared to start him as a true freshman? Well, I think the biggest thing in 2021, Carroll City Kane, would just be the fact, honestly, that it's Alabama. Like, if we were opening up with, you know, App State or Bethune-Cookman or something, it wouldn't be that big of a deal. But, bro, it's Alabama.
Like, I don't want to start Garcia. I think Coop's 100% right. I'm afraid that Manny might force Garcia's.
Yeah, like TVD, if King's not healthy and ready, like I said, physically and mentally, TVD has a year under his belt already with the offense. So, I mean, I think TVD makes the most sense for Alabama.
I think the same. And that's why I'm saying that's what scares me is because Manny doesn't seem to think the same as a lot of us. He don't seem to think that way. Like I said, if you just look at the defensive linemen that, or the linebackers that these young linebackers that we know are better than some of the linebackers.
Don't get me started on linebacker talk.
So, hey, let's go. Let's go. I mean, I'm off tomorrow. I mean, let's go. We know that they're better linebackers, but he won't play them. Why?
Yeah, I know. I mean, it's the seniority stuff and favoritism has definitely been an issue with the program for a while, but also that includes with Manny Diaz too. It has absolutely been a problem.
And what bugged me out about it, I remember the video because I was so proud. As soon as he said it, I went and made it live. I mean, I went to upload. When he said, when Mark Rick was blaming the players and him, Mark Rick got in that big argument on the sideline, he said, I will never blame players. And then the next year when you became head coach, you started blaming players. And I'm like, that's that no new taxes, but I'm going to bring all the old taxes back.
Man, Edward Hobson says, just think they put McLeod out there at defensive end. That was the dumbest thing ever, in my opinion. I'm sorry. But the dude, I know he saw some snaps at defensive end in high school, but literally your entire college career you've been playing linebacker, and then the coaching staff praised him and said, hey, man, he's been looking good at practice at defensive end, and I know we needed some extra help there with guys opting out and whatnot, but McLeod is not going to succeed as a defensive end. I'm sorry. It's just not going to
work. He got one good play. He got a tip interception that he didn't give us.
Yeah.
That was not a good play. But
I want everybody to succeed. But I have to – we got to put ourselves in a good position to win. And McLeod, when he's on the field, he doesn't necessarily put us in the best position to win. I'll be nice. I'll say that. Okay.
Because he's slow-footed. He's and another thing is, though, like I tell people, like, people don't remember even Manny Diaz's best years. We got beat over the top a lot.
When a lot of it, too, that's why I wanted to see a lot of the young players, because I feel like some of it, like for me, it goes both ways. It's both sides, players and coaching. But a lot of it with some of our older guys, I feel like some of it did fall on development and coaching, because it seemed like when some of the younger guys played that hadn't been coached up as much by our staff at Miami, it was almost like I feel like they played better because they had to rely more on their instincts, as opposed to some of the coaching with techniques and other things that they had been taught, and they played and looked better because of it. I'm just putting it out there.
That's the confusing part, is because I just don't know which way Manny wants to go. I don't know which way he's loyal to a fault to some players. It's his system that we're running. It's not like it's not his system. The only difference is we have younger players in it, so they have to back up more. You can't, you know what I'm saying? But answer this question for me. Why did the defense look so much better when Perry got in the game against Oak State? Is it because they felt like they had they had a better chance to win? You think it was mental? Because the same thing happened with Virginia Tech last year. The defense looked bad in that game, and Perry got in, the defense looked a lot better.
I don't know.
Because you know that happened hand in hand.
Yeah, I mean it's not just coincidence.
Yeah, they scored 3 straight touchdowns. Then we came, then they got a stop. Then we came and got a touchdown, the field goal. And then as soon as he got hurt, the defense just started balling out. And the same exact thing happened last year with Virginia Tech. We were getting killed. Defense giving up 1,000 points in the first quarter. And then as soon as Perry get in the game, we game next. We right there to win it. So I truly believe that if I feel like I have a better chance to win with somebody else, I'm going to play harder. But when me at work, I'm gonna bust my ass regardless. But right. At the end of the day, these are young kids. So if they feel like they got a better chance to win, because – I'll play ball, just to be honest. Like I said, and this is not me knocking King. People are like, I'm knocking King, and I'm not. But I played ball with him in the offense. It was very predictable and vanilla. It's a rollout pass, almost like a jump pass, or him tucking and running, or read option. No. They can't. His arm wasn't even strong enough to run a dig route. I saw like four or five big. That's a hard route to run because that ball has to zip there.
Yeah.
You know? So, I just, this is what scares me about Manny Coop. It scares me. It's like the infamous one said, his stubbornness. That's what scares me. Stubbornness.
And I hate it because I really, really want to like him. I really do.
Me too. I rooted for him. I wanted him back. I was like, don't go, come back.
I saw somebody say, let's say TBD looks good the first few games in 2021, then King comes back. What do you do? That's why I said that I think it was a smart decision for Perry to leave, is because it doesn't matter who starts those first few games when King is ready. I'm not saying that I dislike King. Like I said, I like him, but they'll put King back in. He'll be the starter.
He'll be the starter.
I mean, I'll tell you this. The only way that TBD would continue to start for the 2020 season is if he started against Alabama and somehow a miracle happens and the stars and planets align and we beat Alabama. If TBD played and we beat Alabama, it'd be hard to argue. It'd be hard to bench him if we come out and beat the number one or number two team in the country. And it's our start in his college career. Like, come on, it'd be hard to bench him after that.
Not if you, Manny Diaz. I went after Garcia. Me and my daddy flew to his house. Okay? He's my guy. I'm going to play him. I don't care if we beat Alabama. Don't matter. Because Garcia is my guy. Well, this is Red Lassie, but I like TV. He plays. He's better. Listen, Red. Did you go to Garcia's house? No, I went to Garcia's house. He's my guy. Am I the guy in charge? He's my guy. You're playing him. That's how I feel. Manny is, because if you notice, like, no coach. Like, I've seen coaches at least, you know, challenge other coaches. Like, no coach even challenges. Everybody he hires has no. This is why they didn't want Alonzo Highsmith around the campus. It's the reason why they didn't want him on campus. He doesn't want anybody to challenge his authority because I like Manny, but he's just stubborn.
I'm kind of curious, honestly, how long Ed Reed is going to stick around as chief of staff.
I'm gonna tell you this here. I think Manny will be gone before Ed gone. I promise you. I swear if Ed snaps his finger, Ed has that much pull in my, you know, this is Ed. This is Ed has more power than Alonzo Highsmith. This is Ed. If Ed snaps his finger and say, call The Rock and say, The Rock, don't donate another dollar. If Ed snaps his finger and say, I need every form of hurricane in Miami today, and we're going to Julio Frank's office. Every Miami Hurricane gonna show up. And they say after that North Carolina game, they say he cursed Manny out.
I mean, I wouldn't doubt it.
I'm talking about, they say Manny was shook. If you notice, Manny kind of stays away from Ed.
Yeah, I don't really see them talking much on the sideline during games. Usually Ed is over kind of by himself, like eating some peanuts or whatever that is he keeps in his pocket.
I've seen him talk to Blake Baker. I don't see him talk. I've seen him like point little things out to Blake Baker, like, you know, I don't see him talking. I don't think Ed respects Manny. I could be wrong, but it's hard to when you see the favoritism and some of the decision making and the back and forth. And like I say, I want Manny to succeed. I do. I truly do.
Yeah.
Because if he succeeds, Miami succeeds.
And I'm in the same boat, but I hope that we can address and figure out all these things, because I hate that we always seem to find ourselves in these weird little scenarios and situations with coaches and stuff.
I could tell you this right here. People think I'm crazy. If Manny Diaz was a defensive coordinator, for Al Golden, if you'd have fired D'Onofrio Slow, if Manny Diaz was That Al Golden will still have a we'll probably be playing World Championship.
Yeah,
because we were not a bad team. People kill Al Golden. The only way we can kill Al Golden is because he did not fire. He did not fire DeNorfio, and Al Golden was offensive line coach. He was not a defensive coach, so he knew nothing about coaching. Manny Diaz went straight from a defense coordinator to a head coach, and your defense. And your defense looks like this, it makes you to me. It makes you look even worse because you're a defensive guru. Because
what I hate, I keep making the argument that I want Manny to get rid of Baker, but then I also want Manny to bring in a guy with a lengthy resume who can actually come in and Manny hand the reins over completely. I honestly don't even want Manny involved with the defense anymore. I know that there are a lot of people that do like his defense, at least when he was calling plays, because he was a little more aggressive and less predictable. But honestly, I want somebody to come in defensively that just changes everything up. And I want Manny to hand it to them and say, here's the keys. Here you go. You do what you need to do. And people have told me I'm stupid because they said, well, Manny's the head coach. So, of course, he has a hand a little bit in everything because he's the head coach. He's over all of it. But
you see my face? This is what you did. You're talking to Manny right now. When you're saying that, is sitting home watching you right now, and Manny's saying,
"Bro, no, listen, he's hand over the reins, bring in someone who does something totally different that has nothing to do with Manny's defense or anyone else, Baker, whatever you want to say, and let them take over and do their thing, and then Manny can sit back and be the head coach."
Manny is saying, I will hire you, Coach Coop, to coach the defense. I'm going to tell you what plays to call, and then I'm going to blame you.
Count me out.
He is not bringing nobody in. And listen, Manny is this not. I tell people say they said they're going to open up. They opened up money last year. They opened up money the year before last. Manny went down to Louisiana Tech. He didn't have to go to Louisiana Tech. He could at least went to Arkansas State. He went to Louisiana Tech to get his friend.
If he's not willing to let go of the reins with the defense, then I say that the sink will ship, and he's going to go down with it.
Dennis Cooper, you are so wrong. Dennis, let me explain to you about this. This is what I love about being a season ticket holder, because I actually get some finances. Miami has a lot of money. Miami has a lot. They have a ton of money. And one of the best, matter of fact, this year, the best indoor practice facility in the nation. Like, they have a lot of money. They have money to hire a coach. This is not the Donna Shalala. You guys need a little bit of history on Julio Frey. He's a football guy. So he's not taking money from the football program and putting it to the medical facility. He's taking money from the football program and putting it to the football program. And even though Miami doesn't like have a lot of fans go to the games, just look at the YouTube community by itself, the most dominant YouTube community, period. Look at all the Hurricane stuff that people buy. Coach Coop lives in Tennessee. I bet you there's 1,000 Hurricane fans that are somewhere near around Coach Coop. Because I get them all the time. Like Tennessee, Miami Hurricane has the largest fan base spread around the country. And so when you see bumper stickers and hats, like Coach, we see all that stuff.
Oh, we have fans all over the world. Exactly. Not even just the country.
Exactly. So when you see all that Hurricane stuff, right, Miami gets money from that. Miami gets money from us doing these YouTube videos. Miami gets money. They got money. So they can hire a defense coordinator. They don't have Texas money, but who the hell has Texas money? Alabama. Don't have Texas money. What did Texas offer Nick Saban? Like $8-9 million? And that's Alabama. And it might have been like $9 million. And Alabama ended up selling Alabama for like $3 million less.
Now, according to everyone's favorite athletic director, Blake James said, right? He told us that Manny has all the resources that he needs, that if he wants to make a change or do something, that he can.
I tell you this right here.
So
that's what I'm saying. Miami has. I'm not a Blake Baker fan, but the one thing I can say about Blake is he knows how to go get money. He is a fundraiser. And so you need that as an AD, but at the same time, he gave everybody what we wanted. I can't even get mad at him. I didn't want Rick, but a lot of people wanted Rick.
I did. I'll admit it. I didn't want him.
You might want to put that video out before he got fired from Georgia. I watched him at Georgia. I don't want him. But he gave 98% of the fan base what they wanted. Right? And went and spent money. And then he did the same thing this time. So for everybody who don't like Blake James, right, he gave us what we wanted. What's your reason for not liking him? Because he gave you what you wanted. You wanted Manning, you wanted you the two coaches that you wanted, you got. And he fired Rick when everybody wanted Rick fired. When people say Manning made some changes last year, so is Blake.
Yeah.
And he listened to people and gave people what they wanted. Be careful what you wish for sometimes, though.
Oh, yeah. I've learned that one.
That's the reason why I can't. That's the reason why I can't hate on Blake, is because he gave me what I wanted. I think I'm ahead of times with the stadium talk. Listen, bro, if you have never been to the Rock, you have. I don't want to go nowhere where I have to sit on bleachers and a butt pad with no sun cover in Miami. You've been to the Rock.
Man, when I was there, Miami versus FSU 2018, right as the sun was setting and Nkosi Perry started that comeback. I have nothing but good memories at Hard Rock Stadium.
How loud is that stadium?
Oh, it was super loud. I left with one of the worst migraines I've ever had in my life after I left that game.
I don't understand why people say we need a stadium. Bro, we got the best stadium in college football.
No, I like Hard Rock a lot.
And plus, it's in like most of the – you think about it. They say an on-campus stadium, Coach Cool. Miami has 15,000 students, right? 16,000 students, right? All of them get bused to the game, and the student section is full every game. The majority of Miami fans live in the city, not in Coral Gables, in the city. So it's in a perfect spot in Miami Gardens to where it's easy to get to. There's no reason why you shouldn't. So you try to go to Coral Gables and get in and out of there.
And I mean, at the end of the day, if you're playing for Miami, you're getting your home games. You're getting to play in an NFL stadium in college week in and week out for your home games. So
And they have their own locker room. None of that shit sharing. They have all their own stuff there. They have their own facilities there. And then you have a version of Club Live, a little small version of Club Live inside the stadium. Miami Hurricane fan that complained about the stadium, you've never been there. That's all I can. You've never been to the Rock. I like it. I love it. You got the fans, the canopy. It's not too hot, not too cold.
Everybody's saying that you rent your stadium. Man, they're just trolling. They're just hating. They're just trying to stir the pot.
Everybody rents their own. Everybody, South Carolina Gamecocks don't own that stadium. The city owns that stadium. They can pull it from them anytime. Every college team, the fairgrounds is held at their stadium.
Look, I'll say this. I get because people associate – listen, the Orange Bowl was great, and people associate that with winning. I get it. But tell me this. Tell me this. Everybody in the chat, there's still almost 150 people in here. Listen. Let's say we've been working on a stadium, an on-campus stadium. Do you think that on-campus stadium in the 2021 season – would change the outcome of the amount of games we win versus playing at Hard Rock Stadium? Be honest with me. Do you think that having that on-campus stadium would make that big of a difference for our record in 2021?
I got a better question for you.
Give me yes or no. Give me yes or no. It's kind
of got it. Yes or no. Yes. Put a Y or N.
Would it change our record?
Would it change our – put a Y or no. Put a Y or N there. Yep. Let's see.
There's a little delay. I mean, like I said, it's hypothetical.
Nope.
Nobody truly knows. But at the end
of the day,
no. No.
Hey, Shay, how you doing?
It wouldn't make a difference.
I got another question for you. Would it make people go to games?
No.
You got to go out further.
Absolutely. How, though?
You would have less people.
Why? How would it lead to more wins in 2021? Because we're playing in an on-campus stadium.
No, he said no. He said no.
Oh, okay. I got you. Man, I'm feeling a little fired up.
Everybody's saying no, except for G Logan. I ain't paying. And then what? This is the question. The funny one. This is the funny one. Look at that. Yes, if we develop players now, we would win. What are you talking about? Yes.
Dennis says stadiums don't change anything. Coaches and players do.
I cannot believe RG just said yes if we develop players. What?
Well, I think it's about time for me to go. I'm about to
talk now. Oh my God. Hey, some of the stuff people say, cool. Yes, if we develop players. If we develop players now, we would win. Oh my gosh. I can't take it no more, cool. I can't take it no more. Hey, this was the best show I've had. This was.
Like I said, man, it's all about even when it's hot topics. Like I said, I'm heated talking about Nikosi Perry. Even when it's hot drama filled topics, man, it's just all about having fun. It's all about if anybody disagrees with me, I love still engaging with that person and discussing it and talking about it. I just want at the end of the day, we all just love college football. Most of us here love the Miami Hurricanes. There's a few fans of opposing teams because, of course, they're always watching. But it's just fun just to talk football and hang out, chill, have a good time.
I like to zoom in too, Victoria.
I gotta be dramatic.
I got a nice camera, but mine don't do the zoom in.
I'm not even gonna talk about what I paid for this camera.
Yeah. I'm out to get me one. I gotta get me one of them. Like Bear Bryant said, he gotta get. I gotta get me one of them. I gotta get me that zoom in. I gotta have that next year. Now I'm not. I'm gonna leave that alone. That's Coop thing. I gotta leave that alone. But listen, Coop man. We got to do this again, man. We got to do this on your channel next time. You talked me off the ledge, and I ain't gonna lie. Victoria talked me off the ledge last week. And you talked me off the ledge.
How about this? I mean, let's be honest. I'd do it anyways, but let's see what they say. Okay. Do you guys want me to come back and do another show over here? I'm polling. I'm all about participation. I'm trying to see if you guys can steal away. It's 11:30. You guys want me to come over here and do another show sometime? Yes or no? If you say no, fine. I'll never come back again.
Hey.
Let's see. We need some Jeopardy music or something.
Hold on. Hey, go ahead, Google. Play Jeopardy. Oh, I got the mic off.
Let the people speak.
The mic's back on.
Hey, Google. Play the Jeopardy theme song.
Jeopardy main theme by Geek Music. Sure. Playing on YouTube Music.
Oh boy. I'm sweating bullets, bro.
You got me playing Jeopardy.
All right, fine. I'll do it.
I ain't know I had a beat to it.
I'll do it.
Hey, Coop, I could
freestyle to that.
I ain't know I had a beat to it, man. Hey, Google, stop. I ain't know I had a beat to it, Coop.
The mic's off.
You said you got to get one of these cameras. I got to get one of those.
That's just a Google Home. I'll send you one. I got an extra one.
I don't have one.
I've seen one. I'll send you one. I got one. I got an extra one upstairs I'm not even using. So I'll send you. I'll send it to you.
All right.
I'll send it to you. Just DM me on IG.
I still gotta send you your shirt. I'm not gonna lie, I haven't forgot about it.
Oh no, you good. I mean,
when I ended up getting sick and stuff, I dropped.
That's what I'm talking about.
I've got a bunch of them to send out.
I'm talking about cool. I know you. I'm telling you, you can ask Victoria. I'm telling you, like every week we send out a prayer for you. Cause even when you do your live streams and I'm in there. It kind of hurts me a little bit because I could look at you and I can tell that you
I don't feel good. I'll be straight up and honest with you.
And I can say we've been working together for five, even though not doing a lot of shows. Like we usually talk more often, and that's how I know you. Yeah. You've been sick, and I was like, I tell everybody in the chat, like, let's keep our prayers up for Coop, man.
That's what I told people in 2020 when I see, like, people would pop in and, you know, I'm like, I appreciate it. Like, people were like, hey, Coop, you look like you're feeling better. You're doing good. That's awesome. And they didn't realize that a lot of the games this season, I'm not even joking with you. At halftime, I was going to the bathroom and throwing up, cleaning myself up, and then coming back to finish the rest of the game. I'm not even playing. It was rough as heck, man.
People don't understand. They think you two, and like me going through my divorce last year. People think when you do YouTube, it's like, you know, and you block everything out. And you truly don't.
We're just regular dudes.
You don't.
Come on here, passionate about the University of Miami, voice our opinion, and try to give fans a platform where they can voice theirs too. So,
hey, cool. You know how to do it. I don't know how to do it. You got to tell me. Kane Juice just said he ordered another T-shirt. Which I promise you, if he said he did it, I got to know how to put the link in the chat. I don't know how to put the link in the chat.
It was a limited edition run of that Don't Be a Fan Later with the Sebastian on it.
Oh, yeah.
I can't take it down as long as there's at least one order processing, because the company needs the design on the site to pull to print the shirts. So what keeps happening is every week one more person is ordering one, which keeps it up. So
I'm pulling it down.
As soon as I can, because it's a kind of like a limited edition club. Everybody,
my daughter stole mine.
I like it. It's a dope shirt.
Oh no, that's a fly shirt. I like the I don't know what material that is, but whatever material, it's like a dry fit, kind of stretchy, but it's light. Oh, you know what I'm saying? Real. Oh my!
I did my research on it. If I'm doing something, I'm a stickler for quality, so it's gonna be top notch. Period. Yeah. I won't settle for anything less.
Listen, man, everybody been asking for this all year, and I was telling y'all, we haven't done it. I kept telling y'all, y'all just pray for Coop, man. Don't worry about me and Coop doing the show. Hey,
next time we'll have some topics already planned, and we'll hype it up, because I know this was spur of the moment, because like I said, I saw too much Perry bashing and slander and talk going on, so I got all heated, and I whipped my mic out and plugged my cam in, so I had to come on, but... Next time we'll hype it up and we'll get 300 or 400 in here, and we'll just have a party and go crazy.
And a lot of people don't realize Coop be in the chat and won't say nothing.
I'm always learning.
He'll be in the chat and won't even say anything. And then I'll see him in the chat, or he'll hit me up. You know what I'm saying, and stuff like that. And I do the same. Like I'll be watching him live, watching the game. Sometimes I say something. Sometimes I don't. This is nothing against any other YouTuber. It's just Coach Coop is just different. That's my brother. Like, real, that's my brother. And this is why I feel like Manny is a favoritism thing with Coop, with me. Like, you're not going to be the starting quarterback over Coop. You know, he's going to be the starting quarterback. I don't care if he throw 30 interceptions. I might put you in game a couple times. And then that's my guy.
People have been petitioning Coach Coop for hype coach. Miami Hurricane. But basically, my role is just to go up and down the sideline and just keep players hyped up, coaches too. I'll get in Manny's face.
I don't know. Sebastian might take a little bit of
true. He hypes the fans up though. I'd be hyping up the players in the.
But I think he might get. I think he might get a little jealous.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
I don't want to see him on World Star Sebastian and Coach Cooper.
No, I get my booty kicked, man. I'm 115 pounds soaking wet.
You know, hey, Sebastian might pass out in that damn suit.
True. I could outrun him. Yes.
I would love to see some. Hey, I would. I was. Who want to see Sebastian? Who want to see Sebastian and Coach Coop in a celebrity death match?
On that note,
oh my god. Oh my God! But now you're a real one, man. Coach Goo, you're a real one, man. I know you're tired, and you did over an hour tonight. That's crazy.
Yeah, at a spur of the moment, yeah, man. But I'll head out and I'll let you wrap it up. Enjoyed hanging out, chatting for a little bit, and like I said, let's do it again sometime.
Hey, Godspeed, bro. I love you to death, man. You stay safe. Continue to get better, and just stay in touch a little bit more, man. Hit me. Stay in touch a little bit more, cause I do. I do be worried. I inbox you a couple of times. You know, I do worry about you, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I'm bad about taking a long time to respond. So any of y'all that have slid up in my DMs, I'll see it eventually. I'll respond. All right. But I'm going to head out of here, man. Call it a night.
You got that last one from Edward. Edward just put that one there.
What's that?
Edward just posted something. He just posted something for you.
Edward, wait, who? Where's Edward? I don't see him in the chat.
I got it highlighted. Oh, you're not on the what's the name? I got it highlighted.
Oh, Coop versus Sebastian. I got you.
You want to see?
Place your bets.
Hey, I got my money on you, Coop. I done seen Sebastian almost. I done seen him fall a couple times off that wall. Hey, man. Bro, you be safe, man. All right.
Hey, man. Hey, listen. I'll see the rest of y'all real soon. All right. Peace out, guys.
Oh my God. Hey, I couldn't, man. I told y'all, man. That's my guy. People wonder why, man. That's my guy, man. You gotta think about it. Like 6 and 7 years together, man. And always talking on the phone and you know, and keeping each other up, man. And like Cooper's, he's a good-hearted guy. He's just a good-hearted guy, man. And it's the reason why his content is so great. And the one thing I like about Coop is he's just different. Like I tell you, he helped me be better. Like he helped me in a lot of ways be better. You know, talking to me off air on certain things. He helped me grow a lot. And I give a lot of my props in that. I remember, you know what I'm saying, him upgrading my computer so I could do things and on the phone with me 1-2 o'clock in the morning helping me, you know, do things. And that's the thing for the year, man. Good vibe, man. That's twice this year. That's twice in 2021. That's two times in 2021. The first time was January 1st. And today is what, the 7th? That's two times in 2021 that I got talked off the ledge. Hey, Coop is a real one, bro. He's a real one. He's a real one. That's why I say the family grew so much this year, last year. But at the same time, it was, you know, you get the Kobe Bryant thing really got to me. And that's because, like I said, that's my guy. Kobe's my guy. And that got to me, and Victoria helped me out with that a lot. And then tonight, Nikosi happened, and that's my guy. And Coop came and talked me off the ledge. All is good in Harlem Hurricanes' old head, man. All is good in the world, man. You know what I'm saying? You keep the people closest to you. And like I said, I was wrong about, you know what I'm saying, when I mentioned that, and T2I took offense to that. And I was wrong for doing that. But at the same time, Cooper always be, that'll always be my favorite guy. I don't know what Manny could do to get my respect back. I have no idea what Manny could do to ever earn my respect back. I don't know if he can. I don't know. But at the same time, I still have to root for Miami next year. Because those are my guys. Who wants these headphones? Who wants these headphones? I hate that. All right. Here we go. Hey, just because you're my boy don't mean that I'm going to agree or even like your decision. Tune in. I'm gonna do a show on my birthday podcast, and I'm gonna give these headphones away on my birthday podcast. You already got the championship belt, Victoria. You already got the belt, Victoria. Victoria wants the belt and the headphones. I'm going to give these away because I've had so many people ask me about these that I'm going to I'm not definite. I have to make sure I can still find this logo again so I can make me another pair. But if I can find this logo again, well, I can make me another pair. I'm going to do my birthday podcast, and I'm probably going to give them away. She's it. What do you say, Edward? Tell your dad I said happy birthday, man. Hey. Your sister sent me a friend request too, Victoria. Your father sent me a friend request and your sister sent me a friend request on Facebook. So... hey, y'all give a round of applause, man, for Coach Coop coming in tonight, man. Y'all give a round of applause for Coach Coop coming in and blessing us with his presence, man. All right, listen, I want y'all to, we're going to end it on this right here. We're going to end it on this right here, man.
The mic's back on.
We're going to end it on this right here. Hey, Google, play DMX Prayer 1 through 5.
Playing DMX Prayer 1 to 5 on YouTube Music.
I come to you hungry and tired.
Hey, Google, max volume.
I come to you weak. You give me strength, and that's deep. Call me a sheep. and lead me to green pastures. Only asking that I keep the focus in between the chapters. You give me the word and only ask that I interpret and give me the eyes that I may recognize a serpent. You know I ain't perfect, but you'd like me to try. Unlike the devil who just wants me to lie till I die. Lord, why is it that I go through so much pain? All I saw was black. All I felt was rain. I come to you because it's you who knows. Show me that everything was black because my eyes were closed. You gave me the light and let me bask in your glory. So it was only right that when you asked for this story, I put it together to do our dogs some good. Our dogs being brothers and sisters in the hood. Plenty of times you sent help my way, but I hid. And I remember once you held me close, but I slid. There was something that I just had to see, that you wanted me to see so I could be what you wanted me to be. And I think I've seen it, but I don't feel the same. Matter of fact, I know I've seen it. I can feel the change. It's strange. It's got me beating down your door. But I've never known love like this before. It's a wonderful feeling to get away from the pain. And up under the ceiling, I get away from the rain. And the strain that I feel when I'm here is gone. I know real, so I wipe away the tear song. And I almost lost faith when you took my man, Monty, Paso, and Dre's brother, Dad. And I fear that what I'm saying won't be heard until I'm gone. But it's all good, because I really didn't expect to live long. So if it takes for me to suffer, for my brother to see the light, give me pain till I die. But please, Lord, treat him right.
Hey, Google, stop.
The mic's off.
No matter what you go through in life, man. No matter what you go through in life, just remember, man, no matter what you go through in life, nobody can stop your growth but you. Keep people in your corner. Keep people in your corner. That's going to keep bringing you positive vibes, man. And you're going to succeed. So I appreciate each and every one of y'all for everybody. Like I said, I get choked up sometimes because just because I love you guys so much, man. I love you guys. I'm out, man. Y'all be safe, all right?